What? New video? Already? Really? Fine. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to a new video. Good to see you all again, which of course is just a formality because I don't see anyone. I just assume that most of you will be watching this video. Good to see all my friends from Facebook and Instagram and wherever. And I suggest that people who don't have any friends or that aren't my friend or that don't particularly like me, just go ahead and make some coffee in the meanwhile while we get through this video. What? But I thought we were... No. There we go. So, I'm having myself a Desperado, and you'll probably think to yourself, like, dude, what the hell are you doing with a bottle of lemonade, which it basically is, because you normally drink coffee or strong Belgian beer or whiskey or whatever. Well, funny thing happened, last Saturday was my birthday, and I have a little neighbor, a little girl, she's 8 years old, and she always comes to my backyard for a chat. And last Wednesday, after my birthday, she came in and she sat on the table and she was like, hey, it's gonna be my birthday next Friday. So I told her like, hey, what a coincidence, my birthday was last Saturday. And she's just a really nice girl, always coming in for a chat. And I showed her Zeus, the Burmese python. She wasn't scared at all. She really liked him. So, yeah, just a really nice girl. And I was like, you know what? I'm just going to go to the ATM, get a 10-euro bill, put it in an envelope, and shove it through the door. So that's what I did. And then an hour later, she came with a 3-pack of Desperados with her bigger sister. And she was like, hey, this is still for your birthday. She packed it in with a bow on it and whatever. And when I saw it on television, Desperado tequila flavored beer, and I was like, ugh, you know, that's gonna taste horrible. But she came in with that 3-pack, and I was like, hey, let's waste not alcohol. So I opened one, and I was like, it's actually pretty good. It's pretty sweet, and just like I said, it's basically lemonade, because you just pour it away like lemonade. And I showed it on Facebook. I was like, hey, I'm having myself a Desperado. And a lot of people are like, yeah, you should put a piece of lime in the neck. That tastes a lot better. And I was like, it's 10:30 in the evening. Where the hell am I going to get some limes now? But yeah, it's not the best stuff in the world. But for a hot day, just like today, it's really sunny outside. Just tastes, well, pretty good, actually. So I'll just take a sip. I'm just going to put it over here. So... I wanted to make you guys a new vinyl video. I have 5-6 bands which I want to show you guys. I have some vinyl that has been sent to me by either a label or the band themselves. And I just wanted to promote that, show you guys what has been released on vinyl and show you the bands. First, I want to show you a few releases from EMV. And I talked about this before. EMV is a Facebook page as well as a label, because there have been 3 releases so far by EMV. And EMV stands for Extreme Metal Vinyl. It's also a Facebook page. I'm also an admin of that page because the owner, Peter Heide, has asked me a pretty while ago to become an admin because I really do love vinyl. And it was like, you know, you're one of those people that tries to maintain the rules of the page. We don't have a shit ton of rules. We just want to keep it extreme, which means death metal, thrash metal, black metal, doom metal, a few oldies like Venom or Metallica. But if you have like an Iron Maiden vinyl, it doesn't belong on the extreme metal vinyl page. And of course, it's discussable whether something is extreme or not, but we are the end judges of whatever is extreme or not. We also want to keep it vinyl, so if you want to go to a vinyl page to post a cassette tape, you really don't understand the main point of the page. So that's basically it. If you want to go, come over to the Extreme Metal Vinyl page. I'll put a link in the description as well. And for the point of sharing more than just extreme metal vinyl. A lot of people were like, yeah, but I also collect tapes, and I also collect CDs, and I collect t-shirts. Peter has made a EMV user page, which is a page where you can post whatever you want, and if you want to share that with the EMV community. You know, a lot of people, just like myself, I mean, I also have a few CDs, and a few tapes, and vinyl, and whenever I get a new CD or a tape, I post it on the user page. And when I get some extreme vinyl, I'll put it on the EMV page. So that's just it, you know. And the user page doesn't have a whole lot of rules. Just don't be a dick. Don't be Baldrick. Baldick. Yeah, whatever. but EMV is also a label. Peter has released 3 albums so far. And he has actually stopped releasing vinyl because he has a little kid now, which costs a lot of money and a lot of time, of course. So it was like, I have 3 albums which I really wanted to release on vinyl, for the first time on vinyl, which he did. And I'm just gonna show you what he has been releasing. The first one is one I have showed before, but I was like, it doesn't hurt to show it again, just to make it a complete EMV promotion part. This one is called Furious Trauma. It's from Denmark. It's called Primal Touch. There you go. There have been 2 colors released of this. And this is, I just took one up to my collection room here. This is a clear version of it. Just like I said, it's from Denmark. It's a really old school thrash metal album. And Peter was a big fan of this album. So he was like, you know, I really would love this on vinyl. And since it doesn't exist, I'll do it myself. So, Furious Trauma with Primal Touch. There's also a 7-inch included, which is blue colored. There you go. The other color of the 12-inch is red, which also has a blue-colored 7-inch. I'm not sure if he has copies left of this one, but he also has a website of EMV where he puts his releases on, and I'll just put the link in the description so you guys can check out if there are still copies available from this. So go check this one out, Furious Trauma with Primal Touch, including that little 7-inch, a great Danish thrash metal album. So the next one is a release that's from 1997. It's from Norway. It's a black metal band, and I'm trying to expand my horizon a little bit when it comes to black metal. I've been listening to some 1349, Watain, Gorgoroth, and a lot of other bands, and I'm, you know, just trying to get into it, and I'm like, this stuff is actually really good, you know. And not all bands, I still don't like the Black Dark Throne. I just like the first Dark Throne album, which is an old school death metal album, Soul Side Journey. So yeah, but when he released this album, he told me like, it's gonna be a black metal band, I'm not sure if it's your thing. And he told me it's going to be Enthrall with Prophecies of the Dying, which is this album. It's limited to 300 pieces, as you can see here on the back. And normally, a lot of labels and bands that release vinyl, they normally press like 50 or 100 in a color and then the rest in black. Peter did it completely the other way around with this one. He pressed 50 black and 250 on a champagne cognac color. And normally I'm a big limited collector, you know, I like the limited editions, but in this case I was like, you know, I actually like the colored version a lot more than just a black one. So I skipped the black one, I got myself the champagne color. It's a really nasty sounding old school black metal album with some harsh vocals and pretty groovy every once in a while. So I'm just gonna take one vinyl out. It's a double vinyl actually. There's also a lyric sheet in there. I hope you guys can see it. And he always puts a lot of work in his releases to make it look good and sound good. So Enthrall Prophecies of the Dying is just a great album. I'm still looking for it on a CD, but it's one of those albums that costs a shit ton, even if you do find it, and if you do find it, it's expensive, but I just keep on searching. So this is the champagne or cognac colored version of that album. And as you can see, it has the extreme metal vinyl logo in the middle on the piece of paper. And then on the back, on the D side, there's the Anthrol logo in an etching. And a lot of vinyl these days actually have that kind of stuff. I also have a Cataclysm and a few other releases that have a huge etching on it. And he was like, no, I'm just gonna see if I can put the logo as an etching on the D side of this album. And of course the other side is just a playable side. So if you like Anthrol, if you like black metal, if you like some old school black metal, then I really suggest you go and check out this album, Anthrol with Prophecies of the Dying, and just another great release by EMV. There was the second one, and yeah, also the front cover, of course, looks amazing. And like it says on the back, first time on vinyl, 2014. There you go, limited to 300 pieces. I'm pretty sure that he still has a few of these, but the first 50, the limited version, always goes on the EMV page. There are a lot of regular customers, if you will, just like myself and a bunch of others, that first get the chance to get the 50, the limited, and if there are pieces left of that 50, then he goes into the sell on his website and on Facebook and wherever. But he first gives people on the EMV page the chance to get one of the first 50, the limited 50. But I was like, you know, I just really love this color, so I'll get that one. The second release by EMV, and it's just a great album. Then his third release is a band from France, and he told me, like, you know, I just love this album, and it's a really good death grind album. And I was like, you know, just what is it? And he was like, I'm gonna release an album of Benighted. And I was, please let it be Icon, please let it be Icon. And it was Icon. This is just a freaking awesome album. I also have it on CD. One of my favorite songs of this album is song number 6, Smile Then Bleed. It's such a energetic and groovy song with some insane vocals from Julien, if I'm not mistaken, Julien Truchan or whatever. Just a great vocalist, really nice guy. I met him on Erotic Death Fest when they were playing there, and it's a really energetic live band. If you get a chance to see Benighted, go ahead and check them out. Also limited to 300 pieces, officially released by Osmos Productions, of course. And he has black versions of this and splatter versions, and the splatter is limited to 50 pieces. This is actually the black one, which I got from him when I ordered the splatter version. He was like, no, I'll just send you a black one as well, then you have them both. So Peter, thank you so much for that one. I'm just gonna show you guys the splatter version, because that one just looks awesome, just amazing. It's a great release with a huge booklet in it, which has the lyrics in there. Just great work, a great release from Peter. He put a lot of work into it to make it look and sound just amazing. So I'll just put the booklet back in there and take the vinyl out. And officially he ordered clear vinyl with a red splatter on it, and the pressing plant made a little mistake, because instead of red splatter it became white splatter. So he was even honest enough, I don't know if you want to call it honest, but he was like, I ordered red, I sold you guys red, but it became white. If you want to have your money back, I fully understand and I'll return your money. And everybody was like, nope, looks fine. And I must say, it just looks really cool. It's a great splatter. I'll just take it a little bit closer up to you guys. And on the other side, of course, the EMV logo again. And I've been giving it a few spins since I had it. And yeah, I just love the album. I love Benighted. In total, actually, I think I have like 4 or 5 albums from them. A great band from France. But this one is probably my favorite. And I was really happy that he told me, like, it's going to be Icon from Benighted on a splatter and on black vinyl. So yeah, another release by EMV. I'll just put every information, all the links to the EMV page and to the website and where you can buy this vinyl if there are still copies left. Not from the splatter, unfortunately, but I think he still has black copies left. And in the end, it's actually about the music and not about how it looks. But, well, you know, as far as you can get a splatter or a colored one, I always try. But if I don't, I get a black one. So, Benighted with Icon, Enthrall, Furious Trauma, three devastating releases by EMV. And Peter, thank you so much for all the work you put into this. And yeah, for giving the EMV members a chance to get a limited edition item. And I'm really happy with it. And I hope that maybe somewhere in the future you'll be able to press more vinyl on, or more albums on vinyl. It's a shame that I don't have the money to do it myself. I would love to, well, do something like this myself. I think there are a lot of albums that deserve a vinyl treatment. For example, just a good example, the album from Man Must Die, No Tolerance for Imperfection. I think that's just an amazing album, and I would love to see that on vinyl, but it costs a shit ton to press vinyl and to make limited editions, and yeah, I just don't have that kind of money, you know. So maybe somewhere in the future he'll be able to make any more vinyl, and I'll just keep you guys updated, of course, if he does. So go check out EMV, his website, the Facebook, maybe I'll see you there. And yeah, maybe you'll be able to score at least a black one of Benighted Icon or Enthrall, and maybe even Furious Trauma. And then we'll just get to the next vinyl. So the next band and the next vinyl I want to talk to you guys about is a band that comes from Belgium. This is an album that has been released in 2013. This is also the album of which it says in the description you can win a CD off. I also have the CD, and I have two extra copies for you guys to win. I'm not going to make an entire competition out of it. You don't have to do anything difficult. Just leave a comment on this video in the comment section, of course, and I'll pick two people to send the CD to. And no matter where you live, even if you live in an igloo on the North Pole, I'll send it there, no problem. It's a great melodic death metal album with a pinch of thrash, but if you think melodic death metal, don't think Insomnium or Incarnia or Obtenebris or Quo Vadis, stuff like that. It's more a monomorph kind of melodic death metal, you know. It's pretty brutal, but it's not as melodic as Insomnium, so don't expect that kind of music. You would actually say brutal melodic death metal, but I don't really want to be held responsible for coming up with a new genre. There's enough bullshit about genres anyway. I'm talking about Arms of War with their album Legions of Steel, and this is that vinyl. It's a great piece of artwork on the front. I hope you guys can see it in total. That's why I'm leaving it a little bit in front of you guys. It's limited to 299 pieces. If I'm not mistaken, there's also a black version of this one. Yeah, you can see on the back that it's limited to 299 pieces. I have number 166, but I have a red marbled, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I'll just put the cover over there and the inner sleeve over there. There you go. I hope you guys are able to see what it looks like. Maybe I can just turn it to the light a little bit. You know what I'm gonna do? I'll just turn the camera towards the light. There we go. And I'll just show you guys. There we go. Yeah. That's the color of the vinyl. It's red with some black smoke or marble in it, you know. So it's a great freaking album. I love the vocals, and I've actually been talking to Roma, who does the vocals on this album, and he told me, like, you know, I'm just gonna send you two extra CDs to give away in a video. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Yeah, I compare it a little bit with, just like I said, Amonamarth. It's pretty brutal, pretty groovy at points, and it just keeps on going, but there's a lot of melody in it, enough to call it melodic death metal, but yeah, the Amonamarth way of melodic death metal, which also is pretty brutal, but there's a lot of melody in it, and that is exactly what this album is as well. I'll just show you guys the back one more time. And then when you open it, mine is signed, by the way. There you go. That's the entire band. And then Roma Siatlecki, which is the bass and vocals. I've been talking to him, great guy, and he told me, like, you know, I'm just really happy that you would be willing to show my album in this video. And he sent it to me actually a pretty while ago. So yeah, this is the CD version of this album, also with the same artwork on the front. That's the back. And although this is a vinyl video, I'm just gonna show you guys the inside of the CD just a little bit. That's the entire band. This is a digipack. There's the CD. And then of course there's a little booklet with all the lyrics inside of it. And just like I said, I have two sealed copies of the album, which you can win. And I already said it, you don't have to do anything difficult. Just leave a comment. And I'll just pick, unless you really don't want it, then let me know that you don't like it and don't want it. I'm just gonna let you guys listen to one of their songs. I'm not sure which one I will pick yet, but it's a great album and I really recommend you guys to go and check it out. Arms of War with Legions of Steel. And two people are gonna be lucky enough to win a CD version of this album. And I'll just put my album back into the collection. And I'm just gonna show you one more time the vinyl version. So if I can find a link to their Facebook or website where they sell this album on vinyl, it's gonna be down there, so go and check it out. All the links I can find, maybe even to some, I don't know, to a YouTube video where the music will be playing, because I don't think I'm gonna be able to let you guys listen to Benighted Enthrall or Furious Trauma in this case. I'm still working together with a company that takes care of, not buying the rights, but getting the rights to use music and stuff like that. You know, it's a lot of work, but there are companies that do that stuff for you. So I'm still working on that. But I think I'm gonna be able to let you guys listen to one of their songs. Go check them out. Arms of War with Legions of Steel.
Yeah. and get it.
So the next band I want to talk about is a band from Germany, and I've been talking to one of the guys of this band called Hans Gruber, or maybe it sounds more German when I announce it as Hans Gruber, I don't know. No offense. But a really cool guy, and he was like, you know, I'm in a band called Kadaver Figur, and you don't need a whole lot of knowledge of the German language to understand what that means. He told me, like, you know, I have some 7-inch vinyl for you if you would like to promote it in one of your videos. And I told him, well, I'll go check it out. You know, I really like to check out the music before people send me stuff, because when people send me stuff and I don't like it, I either have to send it back and to tell them, like, yeah, I don't like it, you know. I got into trouble once or twice with that. People told me, like, I'm sure you're gonna like it, and they send it, and I was like, sheesh, you know, just... And then I have to go, like, you know, I listened to it, but it's not that good. But anyway, I listened to Kadaver Figur, and I was like, this is some serious good mix of doom, death, and grind. And yeah, I'm just going to show you guys the vinyl that I got. I got 3 split vinyl of Kadaver Figur with other bands. This is a 7-inch vinyl together with Holocaustal Cannibal. And yeah, it's some really nasty sounding grind at moments, but also some groovy death metal in it, some doom parts. It's just a great band, actually, and I never heard of these guys before until Hans contacted me, and that is what I like about this music genre in total, because I was with a friend of mine who's from Belgium yesterday, and he showed me a couple of other bands, and I was like, holy shit, you know. So you keep on discovering new bands, and such as well goes for Kadaver Figur. So this is that front of Kadaver Figur together with Holocaustal Cannibal. It's limited to 100 pieces. As you can see on the back, I've got number 60 of 100. And this is a black 7-inch vinyl. There you go, I'll just take it out. That's the side H. Oh yes, okay, the set, H stands for Holocaustal Cannibal, and then on the back there's the Kadaver Figur side. So I've been listening to these 7 inches, and it's just great. A lot of how do you say that, humorous intros and movie intros, and then combined with some awesome death grind. Yeah, I just love it. You have to be a fan of this kind of music. It's not the average death metal at all, actually, but I'm a pretty big fan of it. Just like Wormrot is also a pretty heavy grind band, and it's not for everybody, but I really do like it. Then I have another 7-inch, which is a split between Kadaver Figur and a band called Shit Fucking Shit. Well, there you go. That's the front of the 7-inch, and then the back, there's also a little piece with the songs, a little piece of paper with the songs on it. That's that little piece of paper. I'll just put it down there. This is the back of that 7-inch Shit Fucking Shit and Kadaver Figur. And if I'm not mistaken, this is a colored vinyl. Oh yeah, it's really colored. There you go. Poisonous green marbled a little bit. I don't know if you guys can see, it doesn't really show in the camera, but it's a little bit marbled as well. Great stuff. And also Shit Fucking Shit is also pretty damn good. And I'm just gonna show you guys the inside a little bit. You know, there's contacts with the bands and pictures of the band Shit Fucking Shit, and then Kadaver Figur on top of here. So another great split. They have a lot more splits, actually, so if you like Kadaver Figur or you like this kind of music, then go check out Discogs or Metal Archives, so you guys can see how many things they actually released. A lot of splits there are. They have one full-length album, which is available on CD, if I'm not mistaken. But if you've never heard about his music, don't worry. In a minute, I'm just gonna let you guys listen to one of a song from Cadaver Figure. This one is a split with Depression and Cadaver Figure together. That's Depression, that's Cadaver Figure. And then this one is also limited to 300 pieces. There you go. Your copy is 143 of 300. And if I'm not mistaken, this one is really nicely colored. I'm a sucker for colored vinyl. So when he told me, like, you know, I have a bunch of 7 inches and I have black ones and I have colored ones. And I was like, well, if you do have a color, you know, yeah. So this one is really nicely colored. It's like a sort of dark purple with all sorts of colors in there. There's a little bit of red and black and green. And yeah, it just looks really cool. Dark purplish. I hope you guys can see it on screen. It's a little bit see-through, not too much. I don't know. No, you guys can see it. Anyway, you'll have to take my word for it, and otherwise just go order your own copy if you like stuff such as Depression or Cadaver Figure. But of course, we're concentrating on Cadaver Figure in this case. I'll just show you guys the back of this 7-inch one more time. Cadaver Figure. And the inside, there's a bunch of information about the two bands, and of course, Cadaver Figure as well. So I really want to thank Hans Gruber for these 7 inches. I hope you guys like the music. I really do. Like I said, it's not really your average death metal. It's not Cannibal Corpse. It's not Immolation. It's not Benighted, which I just showed you. Although Benighted is also a little bit of grind, but this is focusing on grind combined with death metal and then some doom touches, if I had to explain it, which I just did. So anyway, yeah, Hans, thank you so much for these 7-inch split vinyls. I think I'll just go around on the internet to search the rest of it, because I really do like your music and I really want to thank you for these splits of Cadaver Figure with a bunch of other bands. And go check them out. I'll just put their Facebook and whatever they have in the description. Cadaver Figure from Germany. I'm not really sure which song I'm gonna use, but I'll use a good song for you guys so you guys have a really good idea what Cadaver Figure is all about. And yeah, go check them out. Cadaver Figure from Germany. So the last band that I have for you guys in this video is a band from the USA, and it's a great death metal band with a pretty big doom twist in it. I've been talking to a guy called Jim Peterson, who's a friend of mine on Facebook, and he told me, like, you know, I know this band called Last Sacrament. He knew them personally, or he knows them personally, and he asked me, do you know them? I was like, no, I've never heard of them before. So he had two CDs, their first full length and their second full length, and he sent them to me, and I was like, holy fucking shit, this is some really great stuff. And that is why I like to make these videos, just to promote the lesser known bands, just like Cadaver Fikir, and releases like Enthrall, which is a really old one, but you know, some people might discover some new music. There are a lot of bands that release music this year which are pretty big, like Hate Eternal, Nile, Cataclysm, and a bunch of other bands which we pretty much all know, but I never heard of Last Sacrament, and I hope that, well, a lot of you also didn't or have never heard of them, because I think this work is just amazing. Then a little while later, I saw on their Facebook page that they were going to release their first full-length album, Enantiodromia, on vinyl, and this is that vinyl. Now, a lot of people were like, is that you on the cover, because this guy has a big beard, but he also still has some hair, which I don't. So no, it's not me, but it's a great piece of artwork, and I'll just show it to you guys a little bit longer. It looks great. Also, the back looks amazing, and it's a limited press of 116 pieces. This is number 77. It says on the plastic cover, it comes in, there you go, 77 of 116, and has been pressed on a clear vinyl. It also comes with a lyric sheet, there you go, on the inside. On the other side, it's just plain white, so I'll just put that over there. And it's a beautiful, crystal clear vinyl. There you go, almost see-through. So yeah, I was really surprised with their music, actually. You know, it's just one of those bands that goes unknown if you don't have the contacts that point you out to it. So Jim, thank you so much. And of course, thanks to Last Sacrament for sending me the vinyl, and for the great packing, because a lot of people these days just really suck at packing vinyl. I mean, it's really easy to bend, and it's easy to damage. So if you ever send vinyl, just make sure to pack it the correct way. I will probably make a video about how I think you should pack vinyl and to send it away. Got a few boxes and bubble wrap and shit like that. I mean, I even had a vinyl that was sent to me by a big label, just in a very small mailer, no bubble wrap, no nothing, and it came with a really big damaged corner, and I was like, I know it's, you know, the music which counts, but I'm also a collector, I like my items to be in one piece. A lot of people are like, what's the problem with a damaged corner, it's about the music. Well, you can say the same about your car. What does it matter if the seller of your car brings your car to your home and there's a big fucking scratch on the side of your car, and you go like, what the fuck, it's damaged. And the seller goes like, well, you know, it's because it's all about driving a car, it's not about the exterior, it's not about how it looks. Yes, it is. So, you know, it's not just about the music, it's also about collecting, about having it in one piece. So thanks, Last Sacrament, for making sure it arrived in one piece and undamaged. And I really recommend you guys to go and check this shit out. I'm gonna let you guys listen to a piece of music. I'm not sure which song I will use, but well, it's a great album nonetheless and overall. So all the songs are really good, and I'm just gonna pick one and let you guys listen to it. So Jim, thank you very much. Thanks, Last Sacrament. Thank you guys for watching this video again. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you liked the new bands, or maybe none of them were new for you, but I hope that a bunch of you discovered some new music. Go check everything out. I'll put every link in the description so you guys can check it out. And I hope you guys will enjoy Last Sacrament, and I'll see you guys in the next video. You'll probably think, like, what the fuck are you doing with a Desperado? You normally drink coffee, whiskey, or some really strong Belgian beer. Well, funny thing happened, actually, last Saturday was my birthday. And the Wednesday after that, I have a neighbor, which is a little girl. She's like 8 years old. And every once in a while, she comes to my backyard for a chat, and she shits on the shits on the table. No, she's not doing that.